So I believe they are all prepared. And it's a fantastic topic. So God help us in Jesus' name. Praise the Lord. God bless you.
Thank you, Pastor. Well, I'm not so sure if you're going to be able to discuss the two topics, but let's start with the word. Praise God. Yeah. Now, our first topic is something that each and every one of us, we're all guilty of. Personally, I know I'm guilty of that. You know, and I don't know why we always do that, you know. Like when we have a job interview and they say, you have to be there 9 o'clock. Definitely, we'll be there 9 o'clock. If it's doctor's appointment, we get there. Yeah, they are doing the doctor's appointment is like maybe 12 o'clock, we get there 12 o'clock. So why is it that when it's Sunday, and Sunday is like, you know, a day that we should be looking forward to. We should desire to, because the thing is, we work Monday to Friday. And when you work Monday to Friday, and you have just one day of the week to come and worship God, and still, a lot of people will be dragging and be like, you know what, I'm tired. I just want to, just at least leave about 5 more minutes, maybe about 10 more minutes. You know, they'll just be like, okay, just dragging and wasting time. And they will come to church, maybe like 30 minutes, 1 hour late. And still, like someone that I know, which I'm not going to mention them, they will just come to the church majestically, like nothing, like I don't care, I'm talking about me. So, you know, why do we do that? So that's the topic for today. And you know what, let me test each and every one of you. Can anyone confidently say that, the service starts at 10 o'clock today, right, Pastor, right? Every Sunday, the service starts at 10 o'clock. So who can confidently say that they were in church, like maybe 5 minutes to 10 or 10 o'clock on the dot this morning? Can anyone say that? Wow, that's good. That is very good. I think it's really nice to keep to that. So our topic, as we all know, why do we come into church? This is the house of God. This is the place where we come to mingle with like-minded people. It's a time that we come to give God praise, to worship Him, to say, Father Lord, thank you. Thank you for keeping me throughout the week. Thank you, God, for blessing me. And still, we come to church late. Why is that? So, the topic is down to you. Why do we come late? Is there a reason? So, I'm waiting for an answer from each and every one of you. Who wants to go first? All right, see you, sir.
Praise the Lord. Sister Buki has just said, this is a very interesting topic, and I think everyone of us are conscious about it. And as she said, if any one of us starts church around 10 o'clock, and I was even about to say that, which is the truth, none of us, even to them, I'm even proud of the first people that even came among the late comers. So it's when Sister Buki sent the message, I was at work, and when I saw the message, I just laughed. And a colleague of mine said, "Why are you laughing?" And I told him the message. Then he said, "It's normal, it's common among you blacks." That was the answer he gave to me, that we black people are used to coming late and even to church. So when he said that, I said, wow, and which is the truth, because I couldn't even give him any reply. I couldn't answer him back and tell him, no, that's not true. Because I said, I even told him that sincerely, that even me myself, I'm part of the late comers at church. So I don't know why it's so common in we black people, everything that we have, except for job interview, because you have no choice, because you just want to get the job. But for any other thing, even if coming to church, going to parties, you invite someone somewhere. I don't know, maybe you need to meet a friend at a train station. You'll just be late for one thing or the other. So I don't know. I don't really know why. And I think we take church for some, not that we take church for granted, because we, just like me, sometimes I'm like, no, I tell my husband, no, I'm really determined to get to church early, that it's not good, we always get to church late and things like that. But I don't know, one thing or the other, we just, maybe that sleep will just be so, I don't know, it will be so deep in you that even to get up, you won't want to get up. But I think it's just because we get to work on time because we are forced to get to work on time, we have no choice. And because we know that if we don't get to work on time, then we will have like a query, like your boss will come and meet you and ask you why are you late to work, and you know at the end of the day, if you keep on getting to work late all the time, then you get sad. And we know you don't want to get sad because you have children to take care of and things like that. But whereas in church, you come late, you don't come, you come early. I just believe that there's, we're not seeing God physically, and the fear is not there. That's just it. The fear is not there, we're not coming to church. So I just pray that the Lord God Almighty will help every one of us. And I just think it's just a matter of determination. That's just it. Determination and organization too. Because when I need to take the children to play group, I bring out their clothes before. But if it's church, I just say, oh, on Sunday, I'll just pick their clothes and things like that. So I believe we should just need to pray on it. And we need to be determined. We need to really put God first in what we're doing. And if we're capable of going to work on time, then I don't see any reason why we shouldn't come to church on time. It's we need to just be determined and believe and say, yes, I can do it. And if I can do it for worldly things and for other things, then why can't I do it for the church? But as I'm speaking, I just hope that next week I'll be on time at church. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Sister Lisa.
Praise the Lord. Like she rightly said, we need determination. But I think the whole thing is about attitude. It's our attitude. We got this from wherever we're coming from. But it can be changed. Like she said, somebody told me it's a lot of black students. I've seen a black church where the people run to church. Back home in Ghana, they run as if somebody's sweeping them with a cane. So we can also do it. It's all up here. It's in the mind. It can be changed. We can work on it. And I mean, we shouldn't have a problem doing it, but it's all attitude. That's what I'll say. If you ask why, I'll say it's an attitude that we cultivated, which is not right, which is not good. We all know what is good for us, and we know that God, like she said, we should put God first. So if people are doing it, running to church, I don't know how they do it. I don't know what is pushing them. But when it comes to Sundays, I really admire that church, and I really admire them. So we can also do it. It's all attitude. So we just need to change our attitude and get on with it, all by the grace of God. Amen.
To me, I don't know if it's attitude or maybe it's lack of planning. Because at times I wake up very heavy and I still find myself very late. It's not about what, that we're taking God for granted or anything. I'm so ashamed to say this. Everything I do late. Appointments, my work, going to town, I don't meet up time. I don't know what is wrong. And I don't know what is causing that. Maybe I'm not planning. Coming to church, I wake up early, like I want to come to church, and I just take the time, like, wow, I was, planning to come to church early, but I don't know what's happening. So, to me, it's not that I'm doing this purposely, it's what I just find myself in, and I don't really know how to get out of it. The work, appointment with the GP, going to town, even the day of my daughter's wedding ceremony, it was late. So it's just, I don't know what is wrong with me. I don't know how to calm myself, to be honest.
Praise the Lord. Thank you.
Hallelujah. Amen. See, I'm saying it's late. It's lazy. We are lazy. We take God. We are lazy. We take it for granted. Because if we know we are going to work 6 o'clock, and we will be there by 6. We know we have GP appointments. We will be there by that time. And coming to the house of God, oh, let me sleep a bit. For me today, if it's not disappointed, I don't think I can make it. Because when the phone was 7:40, and I saw after talking to her, I went to bed again. So it was that I said, would you go to church today? I said, just 7:40. Yeah, you are a mother, you have to wake up. You know you are a mother, you have to wake up and do all your things before coming to church. But to me, I would say this laziness. I'll say this lady who normally goes to church at late, you have been waiting for what for the foot of room for so many years. So one day, pastor came to church and was preaching about this topic, how we don't come to church. So the woman decided, okay, if church starts at 9, then I'll be there by 8 to help them arrange their chairs to their babies. So the first month that she started, she got pregnant. Then she said in her dream, God said to her that because you take my word serious, I've also given you what you want. So this is me, that's why I said, to me, I know that coming to church is early. Because sometimes when we say 9 o'clock, the angels are here already. When we say 12 o'clock, they are here to bless us, give us the last blessing. But it's laziness. And so God should help us for us to come in. Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Yeah, you have all said well. I'm going to start with what Kadisela said. Kadisela said something about we blacks. Yes, it's in our blood, but it's not in our blood to go to work. Praise the Lord. So, we is in our blood. How can we win the white? That is where the black, the white doesn't come to the black church, because if they are there, the people that invited them are not there. So how are we going to, we should start our country. How are we going to win the white to Christ? Praise the Lord. So our attitude needs to be changed. And we talked about, because what we know we are paying, but with God, we are not seeing the physical thing. We are not being paid back for how. I'm sure if by tomorrow the pastor said, okay, for every worker you come, you are going to be paid £20 per hour for coming. Praise the living Jesus. People will come and start 9, 10, 11 to 4. The pastor said, where's my money? Because I'm here, £20 per hour. Praise the Lord. May God change us in the mighty name of Jesus. Because we're not seeing the monetary part of it, but the spiritual control the physical. Praise the Lord. We should be more. Sister Patience talked about a church running. You know where I came from? When I did my workers in training. Praise the Lord. When I did my workers in training back home, you dare not come to church 7. Then they say 6:30, workers should be there. 6:30, everybody's there. Because if you don't come to punish you, but when you start it here, this one is too much. They do it, we run. You see people running because of the time. Because when you get the workers meeting, you are not there as a worker. 7. They will punish you. You go and watch them, you kneel down. You kneel down, people will see you kneel down there. They will ask you. Nobody will tell you. When you know you are late, you kneel down. No need to join. You will kneel down. And God bless Usher. I'm an usher. Usher should be one, the first person to come to church as an usher. Usher should be there first. Usher will leave last. I'm an usher. That is my ministry. We come to church early. I will be the last person to leave the church. So when we talk about meeting on time, is our attitude towards God. Sister Anita said something, which is right. He says, seek God first, Isaiah. He says, seek God when he's near. You can have interpretation, but you can have different interpretation about it. But let God give you an insight of what he meant by seek him when he's near. When he's near is when he asks you to be there. That time is an appointed time. When they say church start 9, God is there. And he says, seek him when he's near. Praise the Lord. A man diligent in his work. What is diligence? Diligence. Who can give the definition of diligence? First of all, what is diligence? What does it mean? You diligence. Bible said he will stand before king, he will not stand before me, men. So please, let's change our attitude. Especially work, I keep saying it. That is why Gavin Gio had workers' rally. He counts people. I'm not saying people that are not working are not serving God, but those are the first come. That is why he needs to be there. As a worker in his vineyard, there's nothing that will make you not. I was telling someone, he said that he's a worker, he didn't come to church. I said, where did you get? Who trained you? As a worker, if you're not coming to church, your pastor must know. You must tell your pastor. You can't just not come to church. Where me and train you, the training me I had.
for one reason or the other, as a worker, you will not be in church. Your pastor must go. Your head of department must go. You can't just say, I'm not coming to church today. As a worker, it's not done. And nobody will do it. So, our attitude towards God will change. Let me tell you, all these things you are running for, all these things will go in time to. By the time you do God's work, it's a challenge. I challenge you, do God's work diligently for 1 year and come and see the reward. Make up your mind from this beginning of this year, God, I want to go more, I want to go extra for you. And come and next time you see me, say, I'm a pastor, this thing you said didn't work for me. Come and see changes in your life. Please, please, I beg you, seek him first. Seek him first. Let's come to church on time. Let's see God when he's near. Let's come to church when you are meant to come to church. And we can see things coming around in our life. Many a time, what we do that we see how you are struggling is because you are not faithful. Because you are not diligent. You try it for 1 year. Sure, let me cut it down. Try it for 6 months. Try your diligence to the work of God and see how things come around in our life. May God help us in Jesus' name.
Praise the Lord. We thank God for this topic, and I pray we will not go back home the same way we came in Jesus. You know, the Bible tells us in Deuteronomy 18:8, it says, "But thou shalt remember the Lord thy God, for it is he that giveth power to be great." I have said all that I need to say, discipline, learning. And I want to put this. We don't fear God. That's the truth. Yeah, God is a loving computer about it. But at the same time, it's a consuming fire. When you put God, I don't know whether we are afraid of putting God first, whether we believe in power counts, whether we believe in power, we don't understand. I came to this country without papers. I never lied. And I never stopped working for God. And I was not a pastor. So put pastor aside. Oh, he's a pastor. Why would you say that? I came like you as you came. Some of us were born here and they took us home. Some of us, we came with our, what do you call it now? Dependent on our husband or wife. So we are made before we came. Me and my wife, we struggled. And we never owe. Nobody ever pay our rent. And for a first 3 months that we live in one room, we never live in one bedroom. And you cannot see us and say, oh, we are there. So God is doing over time to meet our needs. Because it's God first. I came to this country, they told me that before I play keyboard, they say the church won't be paying me. I said, pay me before I play keyboard for God? I said, God forbid. And I fear people. I have nothing to hide. I was jumping from prayer to phone to work. And I never came late. When you realize that it is God that gives you the power to jump around, you put it first. That's number one. I went the first time in my life. That I will miss a flight. Let me tell you the story. And I will tell you what happened. I was going to Belfast to teach school of discipline. And I will wake up on time because I know plane doesn't wait for anyone. I got to it. And before by the time I get to the gate, they said the gate is closed. I said, what happened? And they said, babe, you are late for about something. I said, please. Just let me go in. I said, no. And God spoke to me at the airport. He said, that is how the people of God will be. Hello? That is how it will be. If that is my journey to heaven, I've missed it. Why? Not planning, indiscipline, and you can't bear. When you get to the gate of heaven, and they say it's closed because of time people, I can't be. I thought, I said, let me talk to you. They said, no. Yes. Yes, brass is very common among us, I agree. But let us individually erase that stigma in our lives. If you are thinking all the blacks will do it, then you start it. It's possible. It's possible for us to be punctual and say, my night is night. If they give you an appointment with GP, you don't tell them stories. You get there, maybe try to say they don't know you are sorry, and there's nothing they can do. Then the last one is the issue of planning. Why do we plan and plan and plan and make it to work on time? You're going to work. You know that your journey to work is 10 minutes. You will trek. It's 2 minutes. You will drive. You know what you are doing. Praise the Lord. For us to take something out of United Kingdom, that word was missing. Where you and I came from, look at my country. The main reason why they voted the new man is discipline. He was there for 18 months. And the old one knew that somebody was there. Now, somebody said 74. Look ahead. Because will the end remove the discipline from me? The Lord help us, but we need to help ourselves. The Lord has already helped us. He won't come down and wait. The best thing we do is to wake up in the morning. Oh, 7 a.m. Until now 20 minutes. That is where the problem will start. Do you think if you come before 8 or before 9 is a taboo? No. In Nigeria, Mommy, Sister Patience said, the church is there. I can assure you, go to any parish in Nigeria. There are some families that they do, there are some churches that run 3-4 services. Workers will be there from the first service to the end. Workers. And for you to be called workers, that is, you are disciplined, you are committed, you know that without God you are nothing. Let us invite you. God help us, but we need to help ourselves. We really, really need to help ourselves. And God help us in Jesus' name. Praise the Lord.
Thank you very much, Pastor. Is there anyone, because you don't really want to waste too much time on this, because we have to talk about the next topic. Okay. So, is there anyone that want to say something before I do the recap? Is there anyone? Okay, well, in the absence of that, Sister Bishop has said, it's all well known in Africa. If you remember during the election took place, I believe, March 28th. And we did not get the results until March 28th was on Saturday, but we did not get the result until Tuesday of the following week. So which means Mr. Lissima was quite right that it's in our block. So
how?
They call it
African
time. Yeah, when you go to the Nigerian party or African party, and you know they were like, they were even putting on the invitation that strictly no African time. So that means we are all well known that any occasion like that will be coming late. So we need to take that out of our body or bring it out of our blood, you understand? So that, you know, we will be, you know, structured and everything like that. So even in the Bible, I believe Jesus mentioned something about tardiness, I can't remember, but I think it's in Matthew or something like that, about 10 virgins or something like that. So they were supposed to be meeting Jesus, but because they were tired because they were late, yeah. So they did not, I think five of them missed out on meeting Jesus Christ. So Jesus Christ talked about it, so it's something that we really need to address. So if we kind of like, you know, structure ourselves with discipline, definitely we will definitely be hurling to church. So the next topic is, actually, the topic was, she doesn't promise to mention her name, but I have to. The topic was asked to my daughter, Nicole. You know, as a teenager, I mean, I'm pretty sure most of the teenagers that are here, at that stage, I believe it's a time for them to start thinking that, okay, now why am I here? What is going on? What is this and that? So they would be like so curious to find out what is going on. So I just want to, you know, let you all know, whatever you go, whatever is, you know, bothering you, you need to, I mean, ask your parents or ask people that are older than you. Don't keep it to yourself, because when you share it, then you get a lot of knowledge from me. So that brings us to the next topic. The topic is, why does religion appeal to poor, weak, vulnerable, ill,
praise and ostracize people. Could religion promise to be more temptation to these people? I think religion and God is just something people choose to believe in because it needs something to believe to help them get through life. Also, because the world is tough and difficult to go through on their own, therefore they chose to believe in God or another God in whatever religion they believe. And they believe that this God, when they stick to this God, no matter what, this God will help them through their suffering. So the question is, why do we think that religion appeals to only the poor people and ill people and, you know, like, because when you look at this world, a lot of people that are very, very rich, you know, most of them don't go to church. And when you ask them, they'll tell you, I'm a baby, I don't believe in God. So why is it that when you go to poor people or people that are sick, and they'll be like telling you, I'm believing in God to heal me. I'm believing in God to provide this for me and that and stuff like that. So why is it that only poor people believe in God while the rich people, they just live a carefree life, they don't care if there's God or if there's no God. So is there anyone that can, you know, shed some light into this for us? Anyone?
Okay. Praise the Lord. What I just have to say about the question is a bit complicated. But the issue of a God is meant to the poor is just not to be wrong. Even the rich people to serve God, they just go. But it's just the way they praise their God and when they do their things different. And they don't tell you what they do. If you look at all these people back in Africa, even here, the way they serve God is different. They serve God with everything they have. But because these people, the way we look at things generally, we think, oh, because I don't have money, then I need to pray to God so that God will give me money. But to be honest with you, money sometimes is not meant for everybody. That's the honest truth. So God knows what is meant for you, because sometimes we're looking for more, and God doesn't, it's not, because sometimes you might have no money and you die, they say. God knows everything, not everything for everybody. And also in terms of, you know, I think there's a lot of rules now that, you know, people that are rich, or they don't serve God, or they don't know God or whatever. From this experience I have regarding my job, there's something that said, which that's why they said anything about the first topic about lateness. One of the things that we should think about is the attitude. If you got a great attitude, everything in your life will happen. Everything. If you got a great attitude towards your job, it will be perfect. If you got a great attitude towards your wife, it will be perfect. Towards your job, everything you have, it's just great attitude. But if you don't have that, then things will go wrong. A lot of us that we think we're poor, we're not poor. Because if you can walk up with the money, eat, you don't think of, I remember a pastor then, that was the pastor in the church I used to go, he said that everybody complained we're rich, we're poor, we're this. But you never sleep on the street. So you're not poor. Poor people, you see them on the street. So if you say, yes, oh, I don't come to church because I don't have money. You still have shoes, you can put on, you still have clothes. But because of some of the things we want, there's difference from need and want. Most of all, we look at the one over the need. If I ask everybody in this room now, what do you need? You tell me what you need now. What do you want? You want everything. But can you afford everything? No. So it's just a lot of differentiating. To me, I don't believe the poor. I mean, serving God is meant for the poor or the rich are not serving God. If you look at top preachers in America, they are rich people. And they believe God. They pray to God every single day. If you go to Nigeria as well, people that drop 10, I mean, what's it called, our offering or our tithe. They give tithe everything. But because we're poor, even poor sometimes don't even serve God the way we can serve it. But you just understand it. If you can actually understand that, and we believe that in our head, then things will work for us. I don't believe, to me personally, God is meant for everybody. Not for the poor, not for the rich. Just for everybody. We're not created from God. It's just like, what we need is different from what we want. And if we can actually differentiate the want and the need, we will know we are all rich. Because God knows what is meant for you now, rather than what you're hoping for. It's just like your little child is asking for a BMW. Can you drive? No. And he's crying every day, praying to God every day, I want Jeep. If you don't give me Jeep, I won't go to church. That's just ridiculous. But if you can actually identify it, this is my need now. I want to eat now, I can eat. Not that I want to eat now and I have no food. You can't eat everything. But you're just going to waste. So to me, I believe personally, the God, serving God is meant for everybody. It's we and an individual that will determine if I'm rich or I'm poor before I can serve God. But to me, it's for everybody. Praise the Lord.
Thank you very much, Brother
Alu.
Yes.
I totally agree with what Brother Alu said. The Bible says, how hard it is for a rich man to enter heaven than the camel to the camel to enter into the eye of a needle. We are all okay in the eyes of God. To me, nobody is poor. The fact that I mean, what maybe you classify as poor to God is not poor. We are all doing well, and what you don't need, you don't need it. You don't need to have a lot of money to worship God. Anybody who is very rich and is not worshiping God, to me, the person is rather missing out. Because at the end of the day, it's not the amount of money that you have that will take you to heaven. So, to me, we are all okay. And to me, it's rather the way you are, rather missing out when it comes to God. Amen.
Thank you very much. Is there any other ones that want to say something?
The first one my daughter asked is in two places, even in three. Because he said, in each other God they believe, he still work out for them. Praise the Lord. Because I can see you wrote God's little. So in which other God they believe, and they will ask is true. In which other God this one believe is what you do. They still get an answer from it. Praise the Lord. And we read Psalm 14:1. Psalm 14:1 said the fool says in their heart, there is no God. So there is God. Praise the Lord. There is God. It's only the fool that says in their heart, there is no God. And he asked that question, he said, why do they they rely on the God for help? So the question is like, they rely on the God for help and they cannot do on their own. Yes. My Bible makes me understand that in Him we live. Without God we cannot do anything. So we need to believe in that God. That there's a God that we rely on Him for our existence. We rely on Him for our total being. Praise the Lord. My Bible made me to understand in the book of... Let me quickly open that Bible so that we can read it. So that we know we rely in God for everything we do. We rely in God for our being, for our existence. He said, I can do all things. Apostle Paul said, I can do all things through Christ that strengthens me. So there's nothing we do in life that we don't need God. We need God for us to be. And the Bible makes me to understand again in the book of Acts 17:28. It says, in Him we live, in Him we be. We have our being in Him. Nico, do you have a Bible so that you can open the Bible passage and read it? So you get understanding of it. So that we rely in God for our existence. Praise the Lord. We rely on Him for our being. We rely in Him to live. We rely in Him to have everything. So we need God. The God is not for poor or for rich. It's for everybody. Praise the Lord. And He said that the other gods. Yes, the other gods. God prepared it. Colossians 1. Whoever is there, please, can you read Colossians 1 for me? So that we know that all these gods, that even the one they are serving, is God that created it. So but they choose to worship that God. But it's God that made everything. If you are there, please can you open to Colossians so that my daughter will understand what it means. Colossians 1:16. Colossians 1:16.
By Him all things created that are in heaven and that are in hell, visible and invisible, whether they be thrones or dominions or principalities or power, all things were created by Him and
All things were created by him and for him. So in which any other God, whoever decides to, that God is still made by God. The God Almighty. So if you decide to go and worship Ogun, it is made, it's God that created everything. But they decide to go and worship that Ogun, and it will work to a limited time. Praise the Lord. If you look at the story of Elijah and the prophet of Baal, he said, bring their gods. If you go, Nico, please read that. So you know there is God and there is God. In whatever they believe, they still work to a limited period. Those gods, they still work to a limited period. But our God is the supreme because he's the one that created him. If you read the story of Elijah and the prophet of Baal, he told them, he said, call your God. Also, call your God. Only pour water and call it. Is your God sleeping? But that is what they believe on. They believe in that small God. But we believe in the great God who can do all things. So if a Shango is worshiping a Shango, that is the God he believes. But he has a limited power when our own God surfaces. Praise the Lord. So in which God they decide to worship or to serve, there's a one God that is the supreme that created that God. Are we getting it? So in whatever God they believe, it works for them, but for a limited time. Because we have a God that can answer all things. Praise the Lord. So that is for our children to get the meaning, because they will ask, why is this one a Muslim? We pray and God answer. Yes, God answer. But there's a limit to what God can do. His own God in a smaller G can do. But our God with a capital G can do all things. Praise the Lord.
Thank you very much, okay, Pastor.
Praise the Lord.
I think what I understand before trying to ask is this. A very good question. Because at this age, I pray our children will not be confused. Nico, let me ask you a question. Do you believe that it's God? Are you sure? Sure. Do you believe without the original, there can be a counterfeit? Sorry, without the original, there can only see a counterfeit? No. Let me explain. The highest denomination in this country is £50. Is that not so? In America, it's $100. Is it?
Yeah.
All right. Have you ever seen $1,000 note before? Have you? No. Why? Because there is nothing like that. There is no origin. So if I say this is £50 note, and this is £50 counterfeit, because there is original, there can be counterfeit. Without having £50 original note made by the government of Britain, there can never be a counterfeit. So, we have only living God to be served. Now, let me tell you the Bible. Act 4, verse 2, 12. There is salvation in no one else, for there is no other name under heaven given among men by which we must be saved. The only way through heaven is Jesus Christ. That is the blatant truth. Yeah, because we are growing, we hearing some other religion. Oh, and you see people going to church. You see, these people are not as rich as I think. If you look at Matthew 19:24, which the prophet is trying to read, quote, it says, it is hard for a rich man to get to heaven, as it is Do you know a camel? You know camel? Do you know a needle? So, you know when you want to put a thread into the eye of the camel, of the needle? You know how beautiful it is a little bit. Now look at camel entering that hole. Is it possible? It's not. So, for every rich that believe, because many of them, those who are not the rich people she's trying to talk about, and she doesn't understand what you mean by riches. Is that not so? What she means, what she understands at her age now, about riches is, I have 2 Jaguar, I have 10 houses. Yes, it's true. You are right. I have a jet, I have 5 jets, they are rich. If you look at their caliber, to some extent, those of some of them doesn't believe in God. When you go to people like that, are you born again? You say, what do you mean? You say you are born again, you have a jet. You say no. So go and cry to God. If you know God will give you jet, go and get it and let me see. It's right. But the Bible says a fool says in his heart that is so good. Other gods except the only living God that we serve through Jesus Christ are dead. Check your Bible. He died and on the third day he rose up. The only person. So when you can meet, you see your friends who will tell you that Allah is the way, Muhammad is the way. Tell them, according to the Bible, even I have a video of a Muslim. I think I said this something. Maybe you show, I don't know, maybe. Of a guy that was a Muslim who now converted to be a Christian that was telling us that he was telling his Islamic teacher that Jesus is the way. I will tell you that he said it to show you, I show them. They know, even they know, that Jesus is the only way, the truth, and the life. We pray in His name, and miracle happens. That one, I can assure you, each and every one of us in this room can tell you one thing that will shake you. At this age, things will be coming up. They want to confuse you. Now, let me ask you a question. Which God will say, let's go to Syria? When we bomb them in Syria and the person bomb himself, he's going to heaven. Will you go? But you know that even in this country, the Easter, the general of the Easter, they are going to Syria. Or ISIS, what's the name of the place? It's Syria. In the name of fighting for religion. And they are still saying they are the religion of peace. So, if I tell you to do that, will you? No. So that one alone has given you a little bit of insight. No, I think this is the wrong way. Anytime you are challenged, I will say confused. Anytime that you don't understand any question about our being, pass it to the Lord. Because it will be so tragic if at the end of the day, what we believe, I will unable to pass across you. That will not be a question of Jesus. It is not the truth. Let me tell you the truth. The Bible says, if any man lack wisdom, let him ask God. And I've just told you that the only way to heaven is by through Christ. And God will bless you, Jesus. Thank you so much for the question. So are you okay now? Do you get it now? Or you still have other questions? Okay, you know how to talk. Give it to God, okay? I know you know how to talk. It is well.
Thank you very much, Pastor. Because of time, so we're going to have to bring this to a close. And I'm going to have to call the pastor to give us a prayer.
Praise the Lord, let's put our feet. Father, in Jesus' name,
amen.
Once again, we want to thank you for your gracious to us, for a wonderful God to us. Thank you for gathering us together again today. Thank you for doing that which only you can do in our lives. Accept and pray that God in Jesus' name. Father, we pray that everything that we have discussed today will not stand against us in judgment. In the name of Jesus. Even if the issue of coming late, because we have discussed this today, God will give us the grace to rescue our ways in the name of Jesus. As we pray for the week, that is going to just Jesus' name. We pray for all our children. They will not go out of your care in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
We pray, Lord, nothing will dilute their belief in you in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
We pray that the truth that we know, and as we have given it to them, they will not miss it.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus. Father, heaven is our way, heaven is our home. As we are raising towards heaven, we will not miss heaven. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, our Father. On the last day, we will reign with you. In the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you, our God. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying.
Amen.
In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying.
Amen.
The last one, don't forget, on the 26th of